Simba, say hi to everyone. Hi. Hi, Simba. Wait, cannot. Okay. So this is Simba. One of my male peacock. Okay, he's about 8 months old. And this is Leng Chai. Leng Chai, say Leng Chai, hello. Okay. Okay, here am I resting with all my animals. Birds, because dogs, they live short life, and when they die, it's very heartbroken. So we decided not to rare any more dogs. We have 2 dogs last time. Okay, so here am I. Say hi. Simba, say hi. Hello, friends. Oak here. Wish you all the best and have a safe and a healthy journey ahead, even as you go to work, or even for those who have retired like me. I would like to share, I think it's time for me to share some of my experiences, especially on how to plan your retirement. I know a lot of banks will tell you that you have to save money, you have to plan your savings so it will last when you retire. But do you know that when you retire, when you have all the money, what are you going to do? My passion is to let friends and even a lot of my relatives know that to retire, you need to continue to be productive, continue to enjoy your passion, continue to have the freedom to do what you want. Like right now, I have a dream to have a house with gazebo, with all my pet animals around me, and I can have the freedom to relax when I want, and also in the same time earn some pocket money and income so that I don't have to depend on my children. Some of you have saved a lot, and I know some of my classmates and friends, they have many houses, they rent out, they have a lot of money. But what do you do with your time? And here am I. I hope that I can help you in a certain way. And you can always ask me questions. And I hope I can help you in planning your dream. Right? I started having this dream how to plan my retirement at the age of about 40. And so when I was about 50, I know I cannot retire that early because I have 3 boys needing funds for their studies, and all are smart boys. So Chinese usually like to save and send the best for their children. So I send them to Monash, which costs a lot of money. And for me to really retire at an early age is a no-no for me. But at the age of 50, I start looking for something that I like to do before I retire. So I will tell you step by step. My first thing that I look for is because I love gardening, and I love to have like a mini orchard, which is one of my dreams. Because when I was young, I actually take care of my family, animals, chicken, ducks, all those things. So it sticks with me. And I was the one actually like to plant and beautify the house. Although not a rich family, we just go by, we stay in a terrace house quarters, but whatever land I have, we will plant. So here am I. I got my own orchard, which you can see from my YouTube. And also, I raise a lot of animals, chicken, ducks. All these are for own consumption, especially with the what is happening now in the world. They're using a lot of artificial food, artificial even hormones, even medicine to actually beef up or boost up the poultry so they grow fast. So for me, I would like to have my own food, and I would like to grow my own things so that I will live healthy. For your information, since I worked for the last 38 years in the same company, I only took one day MC for my last 38 years. My MC is because of sore eye, otherwise I won't be taking my MC. So that shows that I really appreciate good health. So now when you see with COVID all around you, those with morbidity, the tendency to succumb to COVID is not good. So you have to stay healthy. And stay healthy, one of them is your activities, what food you eat, and to stay alert all the time. Okay, going back to what I actually planned, I wanted a dusun. So I actually, at the age of 50, I start looking already. So what you want, what you dream, you have to plan, you have to act on it. It doesn't fall from the sky just for you, right? Even for my children's education, I plan for them to actually prepare them to go to university and then start saving for that. They have no choice, they have to start saving because working in the private sector and you're not businessman, your income is limited and some more is one man's salary. My wife not working, she has to take care of my three boys. So what I'm sharing with you, this first part is to tell you that your dream can happen, can come true. You need to plan, you need to put your activity and you need to put your perspective in right order. You cannot be asking for the sky lah. You know what's your income like, you know how much you can actually save, you know how much you can ever afford. So for me, sometimes buying at the right place at the right time is very critical. Like my house currently I'm staying, right? It's a 8,000 square feet land. I actually like this place all along when I was young, when I was cycling to school. I always aim one of these days I will buy this place. So truly, here am I. I managed to get this bungalow house, 8,000 square feet at a very good price those days when it first launched 15 years ago. And just a house is not enough because my dream is to have my own orchard, yeah, my own sangking, all the fruits. And truly, I look for it. And I even pass the word around, ask them, ask any friends or any brokers that I'm willing to pay them the 2% commission if they can get a good land for me. So at the age of 55, with my EPF money, I managed to buy my 2-acre orchard. Just nice, just enough. I don't want to be too big, don't want to be too ambitious, right? To just stay myself, be able to occupy my time and enjoy my own fruits of my labor. And this is just the first part of my short story. What I'm trying to tell you is you must plan, you must dream, you must have focus and know your limitation and do what you can and put it, your energy inside. Put your plans working, not just dream and do nothing about it. Okay? Hope to see you the next video. And you can ask me any questions. Thank you. Stay safe and stay healthy. Just want to show you while I'm recording this, you can see my come Timon, come Simba, they are all looking at me. Yeah, it's the wonderful thing about what I'm doing now. I have all my animals around me. And this is Leng Chai, my parrot. Right? It's a bit old now, almost 18 years old. Right? But still healthy. Okay, see you. God bless.